vocals, because vocals are the thing that often can take the longest and be the most critical.
Yeah.
And then interspersed with vocals from that point on will be overdubs, like guitar overdubs, percussion, piano, whatever.
There's that class. There's that classic photo. I think Bob Weston maybe took of the vocal, like of the
Vocal microphones with the lyrics.
Yeah, there's
on the music stand. Yeah,
on the music stand. It's like, I think it's like right. I think it's, you know, just right there.
Yeah.
But you know, it's, I think it's a RE20 and a 421.
Yeah, and a Russian microphone called the Lomo 19.9.
Lomo 19.9. Okay, because that was the one that was miffing me a bit. I was like, what is that? I've never seen that.
Yeah, those are, I mean, that's a, they're really cool large diaphragm condenser microphone. They were inexpensive at the time because all the German microphones were the ones that appreciated in value. Mm. The Russian microphones were pretty unknown at the time. So I ended up with a bunch of them because they were utilitarian, good sounding tube microphones, but much less expensive than vintage Neumanns or AKG microphones were, or Shep's microphones. So those microphones ended up being pretty critical to the, like, my mic collection. Like, I ended up having quite a few of these Russian tube condenser microphones. I became a real fan of them. I liked them a lot.
Yeah. And is there like a specific kind of, like, or is it like the room, the way it kind of captures the room, or is it more?
I mean, what you like about a microphone is that it makes something sound great, right? Yeah. And what you're listening to on the microphone, I mean, what, depending on what that is, it'll be a different, like, there are some microphones that sound amazing on distorted electric guitar, but, you know, if you put them on an acoustic guitar, they don't have enough detail or they don't sound as good.
Yeah.
There are some microphones that sound great on low frequency stuff like bass drum or bass guitar, but if you have somebody singing into them, they sound kind of woolly and not that great. Like,
yeah.
So what your job as an engineer is to, like, use your sense memory of your microphone collection.
Yeah.
Say, okay, well, that microphone is going to sound good on this sound. Or, you know, you listen to the sound in the room and you think, well, this sounds one way or another. Like, it has an extended high frequency thing, or there's ambient sound coming from behind here, which I'd like to capture. Like, you use what you know about your microphone collection to take advantage of the sound that you're hearing in the room. And what I liked about those Russian condenser microphones was that they were very versatile. Like, that microphone in particular, the 19.9, I had used that as a drum overhead on Dave's drum kit, but I also used it as a lead vocal microphone on Kurt's vocal.
Crazy.